Welcome to another Yon Mountain Adventure, folks. Back up in Glencoe. What a fantastic drive that is up the A82. And I've just passed Black Mount, which is down there if you're familiar with the area, and leading down to Rannoch Moor. Beautiful mountains in the background here. The scenery just doesn't get much better than this, folks. I'm heading off on a wild camp, and I'm heading up quite a small hill. It's about 492 metres, a one called Meal Moor, and there's actually two peaks, Meal Moor and Meal Beg, and I'm going to find myself a pitch somewhere, maybe on the peaks or somewhere in between, the idea being, if the clag keeps off, so far so good, although the weather is going to turn later on, the views looking down over Rannoch Moor should be absolutely spectacular. Looking down over the Rannoch Wall, and then we'll obviously have the Glencoe Valley there with, of course, the famous herdsman, Bugle Et of Moor, with Stob Gerrard as the primary summit. And on the other side, of course, Ben Le Cruillister and the famous King's House Hotel. There's a fantastic vista across there. And the idea is, let's get pitched up and we'll get hopefully get some beautiful scenery, some beautiful sights. Whoa, it's cold. Right, I'm heading up here. Let's go. Fantastic. There is absolutely no path here whatsoever, and it's a total bog. Dear me. Whoa, you'll have probably seen there, there's obviously quite a flow of traffic of stags and herds of deers coming all the way across here. You can tell by the tracks, and this is just absolutely sodden. There's runoff from the hillside here. There's no path whatsoever, but you can start to see in the background here, Rannoch Moor starting to open up a little bit. It's such a beautiful place, and the A82 just cuts right the way through it and up into the Glencoe Valley. But you can see it's dreaking, it's overcast. The weather forecast is going to be lashing down later on. And the winds are going to be getting up by all accounts to give or take about 40 mile an hour. So I've actually brought the Fox 2, OEX Fox 2 tonight, because I can hunker it right down and it's absolutely bomb proof. So we should be safe and sound tonight. But it is bitter cold. I don't know what the temperature is, but it is cold. I'm looking forward to scrambling my way up here and getting a bit of respite from the wind and the cold. Right, Owen, let's make a move. Listen to that squelching. Wowza. Squelch. Wow, woohoo, we've made it to the summit of Meal Moor, and the smallest summit just over here is Meal Beg. Hey, I made hard work of that, mind. Jesus Christ, big fat Geordie bloke with a nigh on 20 kilogram pack. Anyway, we're here and the views are fantastic. It's just starting to spit on moraine and there is some gusts of wind. Now, it's very exposed here on the summit. I think probably what I'll do is I'll maybe dip down just off the summit a little bit, just so I can get a little bit of respite. And in an ideal world, I want to get this tent pitched before the clag and the rain starts coming in. These clouds are moving fast over the mountains. And I've got pretty good visibility at the minute, but the forecast is going to take a nosedive. Oh, beautiful. Right, stop your blethering, Simon, and procrastinating. Let's go and find a spot. Somewhere over here, I reckon. Oh, the views. it certainly makes it all worth it, that's for sure. Well, that wasn't too bad. Fox 2 is absolutely sturdy. I did have it this way, but when I pick up some grass, you'll be able to see the wind's blowing that way. So I've just put the tent kind of facing away from the wind, really, or in the flow of the wind. And what that'll mean is it'll give us some freedom in the vestibules. The Fox 2's got two vestibules, quite big ones as well. So if the wind's blasting this way, I've got the vestibules there. That means I can do me cooking and I can have everything there. It's going to be spot on. Yeah, and actually it's very, very rocky, but somehow I've managed to get the pegs in between the rocks. So far, so good. It's starting to spit now. I'm looking at a weather front coming up over the mountains here. So before it starts getting really pissing down, I'm going to get me stuff in the bag, in the tent. Let's go. Yeah, definitely want to get in the tent before this starts. That's coming across our way. Wow, guys, it's going ballistic. The weather's horrendous. It was forecast to get bad. Forecast reckons 36 to 40 mile hour wind. I'm pleased I brought the Fox 2 because it's hunkered down. But I must admit, this has been really put through its tests, to be honest. Since I got in the tent, it's never stopped raining. It's been lashing down the whole time. And it seems to come and go a little bit, the wind. There's a constant, quite strong wind, but there's some really strong gusts as well. So much so that this main pole that goes across here, I'm seeing it flex in the wind. So we'll have to be sensible here. As much as it's absolutely beautiful, I'm gonna have to be sensible, because it may well be a case of knowing the tent's limitations, being safe and sound, and making sure that, you know, we're all right type of thing. What I'm going to do is I'm going to get a bit of bait on the go. Incidentally, it's freezing as well. I do have something which is fantastic. I've got a new pair of gloves which was kindly sent to us by Unigear. I don't know if you can hear this or not. Heated gloves. So far so good. 3 settings, red being the highest. What's that one? Yellow or orange being medium, and then white being the lowest. For this tent's hitting off my head. These have proved to be a bit of a game changer, to be honest. Really good quality as well. Fantastic quality. So I'll put a link in the description for these. Go and check it out if you want to. Unigear, thank you very much for sending us them. Absolutely class. I'm going to get a hot chocolate or a coffee on the go, get some food, and then I'm just going to weigh up the pros and cons and see how this is going. I opened up the tent just before there just to see what was going on outside. Wait, obviously I can hear what's going on outside, but I've been tent bound for a good 2.5 hours now. And I think if it starts to lose light, which obviously it will pretty soon, and if this weather starts to get absolutely mental, I'm going to have to bail. Bear in mind, there's no path down there whatsoever. And get, you know, it's probably about 1.5 miles down to the car. That could be quite interesting, that. So, Oh, wowza. Right, coffee time.
Well, all right, guys. I'm going to have to make that decision now. I've just given another half an hour or so. And the tent's buckling over. I'm going to have to get myself packed away here. Jesus Christ. I'm not going to film the rest of this. Needless to say, I'm going to get everything packed up inside the tent, get me waterproofs on, I'm prepared, I'm ready for this type of stuff anyway. And also, there's still a little bit of light outside. Fully charged head torch. I'll be able to make it back down the car, no bother at all. I'll check in with you when I get back down.
Oh dear me, folks, wow, what a night that was. The weather was nowhere close to what BBC weather and actually what the mountain weather forecast was saying as well. That was 50 to 60 mile an hour wind, driving rain. That Fox 2 just couldn't handle it. It was too dangerous, had to come off. And it's good to know your limitations, like I was saying just before at the weather station while I was still on the mountain. Anyway, luckily enough, managed to get down to the car. And went on to booking.com. There was nowhere else really to camp. The weather was just too bad. So I've just put myself up in the hotel, which is lovely. Actually, the night's turned out quite good in the end, I suppose. I've just been at the bar. I've got myself a pint there. And I'm just going to cook up my tea. I've got my gas burner there because there's nowhere serving food at this time of night. It's about, 10:45, something like that. And I'm in Tindrum, the Muthu Doran Hotel. Very, very good hotel, I must admit, very hospitable, nice guys, nice girl, down on reception, really accommodating, so that was good, really good. So guys, you've just got to know your limitations, know when to stop, be safe, most of all. That's really the most important thing, you know, those types of situations. You've got to know your limitations, you've got to get off, you've got to know your nav, you've got to have the right equipment, you know, and just don't be daft with it as well. So yeah, that was quite extreme, but anyway, it's all turned out quite nicely. I'm going to get myself a cracker night's kip in here, but first things first, I'm going to have this pint, and I'm going to have my tea, chicken casserole, which I got from the Green Welly shop. Absolutely class. I just wanted to say a big thank you to Mac in the Wild. Check him out, he's got a YouTube channel. He's an awesome guy. The reason I'm giving a shout out is because he's been messaged a few times on Instagram, just checking in, making sure that I was safe and well. So Mac, much appreciated, mate. Absolutely class, and I wish you all the best on the Cape Wrath Trail, which you're going to be doing as well. That's epic. You've been doing some amazing training, mate. Really good stuff. You're going to be epic with that. So guys, you know how this goes, don't you? You know, I don't get caught up with the news and the TV and the radio, newspapers, all the doom and gloom on Facebook and all the rest of it. Get yourself out, get into some beautiful places, you know, and soak up some prescription nature. And if all else fails, just book yourself into a nice hotel. Have a good one, folks. Thanks very much for watching. Stay tuned. I've got another couple of videos coming up fairly soon, a couple of good adventures as well. So we'll see you on the next Yonder Hotel adventure.
Bye for now.